Welcome to another live edition of BPTV and the beep of Pittsburgh Sportsline in the BPTV studio. I'm Al Levine, the talking machine. Chip Painter couldn't make it today, but smoking Jim Frazier's here, and they keep arguing with me whether he looks like Stevie Wonder or not.
Hines Ward.
Our guests last night, they're blind, and they said he looks like Hines Ward. Smoking Jim don't even like Hines Ward. He talked bad about him when he was playing as a Steeler, but he did like his smile. And we got a lot of sports for you tonight. Thanks for watching us on Comcast 7, only in Bethel Park. Thanks for watching us on Verizon 32 in Bethel Park and all the way from Nemacolin to Cranberry, Wexford, and all points in between. You name it, we've been seen there in Verizon. So it's Verizon 32. We're on every Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday night. And Frank Fabus, got to give a shout out to him. He didn't realize all these years we've been talking about having a Tuesday night show. He goes, I didn't know you had a Tuesday night show. When's it on? I go, 7 o'clock to 8 o'clock. It's on, Verizon 32. So this morning, he sends me the pictures late. And I said, what happened there? He sent them from last night's show, so they were good. Posted them up. Then he said he's going to go try to watch our show. He turned Verizon 32 on, grabbed a picture of me on TV.
Wow.
So he ended up seeing our show this morning. So go figure that. We're on different times. But, yeah, check it out. We appreciate that. And then on Facebook, we hit a brand new high, 6879. So thank you for watching our shows and liking our pages. We appreciate that. I got some promos here that we're going to put up. First one up is Olive Oil's Pizzeria. Now the camera's not working here on us, so I don't know if you can hear or see us. My control room guys are a little lax. They're not telling me what's happening right now. So hopefully one of them will give me a little update, but this is Olive Oil's Pizzeria.
We have no idea what's going on.
Thank you. I appreciate the update in here because it looks like we're not even on air. My promo is Olive Oil's Pizzeria, Hillcrest Shopping Center. You can't miss it. Smoking Jim even has been there. He knows where it's at, right on 88. 412-831-1900. Call them and tell them Al Levine, the talking machine, sent you there. Got a shout out to Jason there. He was at Olive Oils in Brookline, and he said, hey, that was a great podcast. I said, excuse me, that was a TV show. He goes, you guys did a great podcast. So I go, again, my man, it's a TV show. He goes, what are you talking about? I go, we did a TV show at Olive Oil's Pizzeria. You saw us. He goes, wow, you had a lot of people in there buying food. It was great. He goes, if that was a TV show, that was pretty good. So I had to argue with him. Unbelievable what happens out there. Next up is the Joey Fabus Childhood Cancer Foundation. Poor Joey didn't make it to his 10th birthday with the dreaded brain cancer, DIPG. Pictures before and after with DIPG. His family's raised over $100,000 the last 4 years to find a cure for DIPG. So God bless their family and what they do, and God bless Joey Fabus. Next up is the Joey Fabus Sunday, September 15th, Superhero Run Walk for DIPG, 5K walk, 1 mile run.
Wow.
and it's a great performance there. We're always filming it, so come on out, dress up as a superhero, get your money in there, and all that money will go to find a cure for DIPG. Again, that's September 15th, Sunday at 9 a.m., Bethel Park Senior High School. It's a great day. They have a lot of vendors and people there, and it's just a good feel-good day. Check it out. And let's see, the next up, Bethel Park Historical Society Schoolhouse Arts and History Center, 2600 South Park Road. My new favorite tea place is Reginald's Coffee. They're open from 7 to 2 every day, and I think on the weekends till 3. Check them out. That's Reginald's Coffee at the Bethel Park Historical Society Schoolhouse Arts and History Center. They have Wi-Fi. Maybe I can coerce Smoking Jim Frazier into having a pot of green tea with me. And they always give me a nice pot of green tea, which I appreciate. Next, Dave Cable makes a little bit of fun of Al Levine, the talking machine. Tell them Uncle Al sent you. I want you for BPTV, 412-831-3304. You can be here like Jack. You can be here like Zach. You can be here like Steve, running audio, video, trying to figure out why we can't see ourselves on the screen. Anything. But I want you for BPTV. Call Dave Cable, 412-831-3304. Last promo I have is for the Bethel Park Community Foundation. Great organization that gives money to you from $100 to $5,000. Whatever you're doing in Bethel Park, they can help fund it. Get an application online. I'm a trustee on this great board. We gave out over $100,000 last year and plan on giving out the same amount or so this year. So get an application and come out and see us. Next, we have a sponsor for What's On Your Mind, Skeets Lewandowski of Skeets Service Station. You can call him 724-348-4715. And anything and everything that runs on gas, Skeets can fix it. Smoking Jim and I have taken our vehicles there. He's fixed this up. I had numerous problems. They help fix it, and they do a great job. They have a Monday morning buffet with Bethel Bakery donuts. I travel 7 miles just to get my Bethel Bakery donut, even though they're 1 mile from my house. Go figure it out, but it's a great place. You can meet, talk, and watch them fix your car. It's great stuff there. All right, we're going to start our show with What's On Your Mind, Smoking Jim Frazier.
Thanks, Al Levine, the talking machine. And if you want the green,
don't break it.
You got the C. Levine, old high school quarterback option days.
What year? What year was that, buddy?
But I tell you what, man, I did something unique. One of my white friends had to get a haircut.
So he brought the race card out early, folks.
So I went to the barber shop with him. And guess what they do?
I don't know.
Once he gets his hair cut, they leave. It's different from the black barber shops. They're here all day, man. Whether they're getting a haircut or not, they're in there talking.
Hold it. At Isuzu, I stop and get a picture. When I'm done with my haircut, I get a picture. So I'm in between you guys.
Oh, man, you can shop at a black barber
really?
Shop, man. Yeah.
Can I get those $20 shoes?
Yeah, yeah.
I need a size 20.
You got to go to the trunk of the car to get that.
I need a size 20. Come on, man.
But, hey.
That's all I'm looking for.
Congratulations to Coach Mike Tomlin.
What happened?
Lost another challenge. You know, I don't know. He's now 0-for-12 in his last 12 challenges. This one don't count because it's preseason. But clearly from the naked eye, you can see Tampa Bay recovered the football. Late in the fourth quarter, they were winning.
I didn't even watch that because I don't usually watch preseason.
Yeah.
I only watched the first half.
He challenged and lost, of course. But, hey, listen, I was opposed on draft day at a Pittsburgh Steelers draft in the middle linebacker and giving up so much to move up in the draft to get Devin Bush. And the reason is because middle linebackers in the 3-4 defense.
Fifth.
I moved him all the way down to six now.
Six.
Right outside linebackers first, left outside linebackers second. They still don't have a right outside linebacker.
Right, right.
Third is strong safety. Fourth is nose tackle. And with all the blitzing, you need at least one shutdown corner. They really hadn't had one since Ike Taylor and before that Rod Woodson. And then you got a middle linebacker. Devin Bush reminds me a lot of Jerry O, a more athletic Jerry O.
Whoa.
I call him
short. But short.
Yeah. I call him Huggy Bear because he dresses like Huggy Bear and plays like Huggy Bear. All this grabbing. Listen, if you watch all Devin Bush's videos from college and from pros, you've yet to see him blow anybody up. I like to see, you don't got to be Kendrell Bell, but I at least
How
like
about
to
Arnold,
see him.
Or Donald.
Aaron Donald.
Aaron Donald.
Yeah, he's
yeah.
great. Yeah, he'll blow you up, except for in the Super Bowl. He took
he
that
day
off.
He didn't need to.
Yeah, he took that day off.
He had all the millions.
He voted the number one player in the National Football
That's
League.
That's how it should
so
be.
That voting must have came out before the Super Bowl.
From Penn Hills. Can't beat it.
He played at a high school near Monroeville.
Penn Hills.
But, again, Devin Bush, one career interception. He had an interception right in his hands against Tampa Bay and dropped it. So,
maybe he has some stone hands.
Exactly. Cornerback Justin Lane was getting burnt and toast all
Where
night.
Where did he disappear?
He was a high-round draft choice, and then he refuses to tackle. You got Benny, slow as a snail, that was running like he had a piano on his back. I did not like that pick, but everybody seemed to like it, and he couldn't find a hole.
26 yards, man.
On what, 26 carries?
No. whatever it was, but 26 yards.
And
the line still got a block better.
Well, they don't have Munchak anymore. I predicted the line would take a step back this year because the coach Munchak was outstanding, maybe the best in the business, right up there with Russ Grimm.
Wow.
And another great one. But I told you that James Washington was playing out of position
you
last
picked that.
Year. James Washington, in my opinion, is the next Sterling Sharp.
Whoa.
And I think he got the best hands in the NFL since Chris Carter. Ulysses Gilbert. I always want to call him Ulysses Grant.
Yeah, that was a president.
Yeah, I don't know. Was it?
Yeah.
I don't know. I knew it was something. I don't even know who the vice president is, man. You expect me to? Was he really a president? I got to look him up.
Yes, he was.
If I'm going to keep calling
this isn't
name.
Black History Month. This is, he was a general in the Civil War.
Okay.
Parlayed winning the Civil War and the presidency.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
After George Washington?
No, much after.
Okay.
After Abraham Lincoln, who freed your people.
Oh, okay. Wow.
Yeah.
I tell you, I got to crack open the history.
Civil War ended like 1865.
That wasn't that long ago. Was it?
No. 150 some years ago.
But then you got 45 presidents since then, right? Or
since
all
George.
Together. Yeah.
Since George.
Don't seem like
you know, the last of the White Washingtons.
Yeah. So,
I'm glad we cleared that up.
But, again, Ulysses Gilbert was outstanding. Two sacks. He had an interception. This is a guy who, in my opinion, is better than Devin Bush. But I think it'll be a year before he gets the opportunity. I think next year him and Devin Bush will be the two inside linebackers. This guy's outstanding. But, and lastly, am I the only man in America that will stand up for the white man? First of all, there's been no cornerbacks in the National Football League on any roster in the last 15 years. And now got my man Sutton Smith, 6'1", 240 pounds, came out after his junior year. This is a white linebacker.
Yeah, yeah.
Playing right outside linebacker position the Steelers need. He's a two-time All-American, two-time MAC Conference Player of the Year. He led the nation in tackles for losses and sacks the Whoa. Last two seasons. Didn't get in the game because he's white. Didn't play in the first preseason game in a position where the Steelers need production This guy was more productive in college than T.J. Watt, who I've been saying, and people have been backing me on it, is the best linebacker in Steeler history. This guy could be...
Who are those people?
This guy could be a bookend, Sutton Smith.
I haven't heard anybody say that about T.J. Watt but you. Sorry to interrupt you. You're on a roll.
So,
but that is a form of discrimination.
Discrimination. And one of the reasons, another reason why he didn't play. Yay! I'm on TV! Another reason why he didn't play is because the Steelers, who need outside linebacker help that don't use the fullback, is moving him to fullback. Utterly ridiculous. And, again, another form of blatant reverse discrimination. And that's what's on my mind.
Well, one thing to interrupt your thing is, since you said Munchak's gone, maybe they figure they need more blocking. Because the line's not going to be as good without Munchak. So a fullback, what do they do?
So what's block. Next? What's next? They're going to move T.J. They Watt block. To tight end?
No. He'll be a fullback. Thank you, Smoking Jim Frazier. What's on my mind is a few things. The Buccos, you know, I bleed black and gold, but it's mostly bleeding out black and gold, because Chris Archer had a good game the other day, lasted 6 innings, threw 100 pitches, had like 9 strikeouts, gave up 2 runs. They ended up having the relief pitchers come in, got blown out 6-2. So.
Wow.
Yeah, it's just been a nightmare with what the Pirates are doing, so very frustrating there. I gave my report yesterday, Devin Bush, 10 tackles. great first game start for him, calling plays. I think they made the right move moving up. I don't care what Smoking Jim says. We needed somebody that was alive that could run from sideline to sideline. So what if he drops a ball? So what if he doesn't cover this guy or that guy? He made tackles. Unlike your other guy, Lane, couldn't make a tackle if he was right in front of him, which they were. He reminded me of Gay.
Yeah.
Catch in front of Lane. But it is preseason. Ben didn't play. A lot of people didn't play, so... We'll see what happens as they progress with the season here, with the preseason. I normally don't watch it, but with all the new players, I wanted to see how it was run. And I was happy with what I saw out there. And it's still early. And, you know, it is preseason. So let's go Steelers. Let's go Buccos. We're packing in for next year. And the Penguins are coming around the corner. So we'll see what happens with the curse of the Penguins, according to Smoking Jim Frazier. We'll be back with some fiction and fact from Smoking Jim's Almanac.
Hi, Bethel Park. Remember me? My name is Jason Planetzer. I was the host of a little show here. You may have seen it. It was called The Jason Planetzer Show.
What would you say your experience at BPTV, how has that had an impact on your life?
I found my voice. I learned how to be funny. I learned how to create things. I learned how to collaborate with people here. I developed an interest in film and comedy and making videos. It stuck with me. It continued through my life. I got into working on motion pictures. I now I'll produce small videos. I'll work with producers on commercials, television projects, feature films. I scout locations on TV shows and movies, which involves me reading scripts, finding the locations that need to be shot, and collaborating with the director and production designer to find the perfect spot. It all started at BPTV for me.
Thanks, Al Levine, the talking machine. Thanks, Rookie of the Year, Steve Fisher. My man, Jack's back this week, my favorite volleyball player.
Yeah.
Zach's in the house. And a big shout out to Little Z, Zach Taylor's in the house as well.
Is he? When did he show up?
He's the one that fixed everything.
No, he didn't.
Picked that up from Gateway.
No, he didn't. Steve Fisher fixed it all. He's my newest hero. He's the hero of BPTV.
He is the Rookie of the Year. I tell you what.
What?
You know what? I'm not really – I don't understand the media's fixation with the Kardashians and Antoine and
Antonio Brown. Well, you're on the bandwagon.
Yeah, I don't understand it. I know that Kim Kardashian's beautiful. But there's a billion beautiful women in the world. Matter of fact, I've never seen an ugly woman. Have you?
No.
And so Kim Kardashian got famous because of the sex video. But there was two people in that video. She's the only one that got famous. So what is it about her? Now you got Antonio Brown. Every time he turns around, Antonio Brown's really no different than most other players in professional sports or your friends. The only difference is he got a camera in his face all the time. And I don't know why.
He might be dumber than some of the friends that I have.
Not dumber than my friends.
He's dumber than mine, man. Unbelievable, because he's done so many dumb things. It's just ridiculous.
I always say this. The funniest guys in the world are not the comedians. Probably some of your uncles and cousins are funnier. It's just that they have the timing. You know what I mean? Their timing is what separates them from a lot of other people.
Well, that's
people.
What I'm talking about in Antonio Brown.
He got the timing?
Yeah, because as he got frostbite when he went to cryotherapy. They want me to do cryotherapy here in Bethel Park.
Do they?
They never talked about you getting frostbite.
Really?
And then I remember my senior year, we got new helmets. They had these things that pumped air into the helmets.
Okay.
That was a big thing back then.
Wow.
Some people didn't like them because the other helmets, you got hit and you could feel it. With the air, you couldn't even feel some of the hits.
Wow.
So we have one guy. Now imagine this. How many players are in the NFL? What, like 1,500, 1,600?
Maybe.
One complained. One. You know the odds of that? And it's even part of their contracts that they have to wear a helmet from the league or they can't play. It's in there. It's a known fact. Tom Brady complained about his, but he's wearing it. He said, I won 4 Super Bowls with that helmet. I liked it. This one's not as good, but I'm wearing it.
Well, did you know in the 50s?
How did that happen?
Did you know in the 50s there was a lot of NHL goalies that refused to wear a mask?
Yeah, I followed hockey.
In the 50s, there was a lot of quarterbacks that refused to wear face masks, and one was Otto Graham.
Yeah.
So this is really not anything, I don't think.
Well, in this day and age, it's a little unbelievable because he even went to Arbiter to rule in his favor, and he lost immediately.
Who?
Antonio Brown.
An arbitrator?
Yeah.
Well.
And he lost.
Well, you know, in the last 30-plus years, there's only been one player in the National Football League who used to wear a single bar. That was Joe Theismann.
Yeah.
And Joe Theismann, once he was done, they mandated that everybody had to wear more protective.
And what do they do?
But he didn't. He didn't have to do it.
Well, he was special.
How about Joe Namath?
How about him?
Joe Namath was the only guy in the league wearing white shoes.
Yeah.
Do you know there was a 32 on the Pittsburgh Steelers before Franco Harris? There was a 32 before Franco Harris.
No, didn't know.
In 1970, a guy by the name of Hubie Brian wore number 32.
I'm glad you're throwing some of this history at.
The Steelers refused. Now, Joe Namath was wearing white shoes in the 60s. Hubie Brian wanted to wear white shoes because he wore white shoes when he was at the University of Minnesota. Pittsburgh Steelers didn't allow their players to wear white shoes. So Hubie Brian taped out the outside of his shoes. Only thing black was showing was the tips. So, I mean, these are some of the things.
I got
that
a little history too. Yeah. Al Levine, the talking machine, was pitching in the early 70s.
Okay.
Guess what color his shoes were?
You had white shoes?
Yeah, white Adidas's.
Wow.
Yeah.
Well, wow.
How about that, buddy?
Well, Gateway to this day don't have black shoes. I mean, they only have black shoes at Gateway.
But I had the white shoes on, buddy.
So my senior year, I painted my shoe polish, you know, that creamy white polish. So I had the white shoes.
Did you?
Only one in Gateway history not to wear the black shoes, brother. You calling me Antonio Brown?
Yeah.
But how about the neck rolls?
Yeah.
Now no people used to refuse to play without the neck rolls. Now hardly anybody.
Their
in
necks
the
are stronger.
Yeah. LC Greenwood got fined all the time because he wore the gold shoes.
Yeah. And what did he do? He kept wearing them.
He kept wearing them. So. Like I said before, Al Levine, the talking machine, I think Antonio Brown has a good point.
What is it?
He's been knocked out a few times.
No, they said so only one official knockout that he's had.
Against Burfict.
Yeah, that was the only knockout that he had.
He had some concussions.
No, but that's the only one official.
Official knockout.
He didn't have any other concussions.
Well, put it this way.
So go back.
Put it this way. The NFL did not rule his helmet unsafe. The ruling is that they will not allow equipment over 10 years old. They stopped manufacturing that helmet basically in 2010. So if he can find one, and they made a few limited helmets in 2011. So if he can find a helmet, which he's looking on Twitter for a helmet of that brand with that serial number from
2011. Why don't he go to Craigslist? Everybody goes to Craigslist.
Maybe he got people working on that.
Then it's not happening.
So,
because your man OJ's on Twitter. They'll let anybody on Twitter.
So I think that Antonio Brown, from a safety standpoint, he can't see as well. He says from that helmet, he's comfortable with that helmet. And just like Otto Graham, who refused to wear face masks, I think Antonio Brown got a legitimate gripe.
But what's he have, a pinhead that he can't look out of the new helmet? He got a small head?
Well, do you know that?
Tell me that one.
Do you know?
Can you touch on the pinhead there?
Do you know that Tom Brady had a $300,000 custom-made car?
No.
And I forget what brand, but here's the point to it.
I don't understand.
How come the manufacturers can't take that old mold for $100,000 and make Antonio Brown?
Because they threw the molds away, man.
No, nobody.
Those molds are go. They're gone.
If you was in marketing.
Look at that head you got. They can't make another custom fit head for you. You got the adjustables.
If you want the green, you got to see Levine.
Yeah.
If you was in marketing, wouldn't you step up and say, hey, Antonio Brown, for $100,000, we can do that.
No, because I'd be like the car models. How come every year they come out with new car models that look almost the same?
But Brady got a custom-made $300,000 car.
But my point is, every year they got new models of cars.
Yeah.
What are people buying, that new model? They can't help it, just like you. Look at the hat you got on. You didn't have that on last week.
That's true.
You got a new hat on. You got a new lid on that hat.
I ain't changed the sunglasses because I see better out of these.
I understand. I knew it was for a reason.
Where's some Versaces? I'm looking for some Versaces, man.
We'll start a GoFundMe page, Versace Frazier. We had some time, so that's why I interrupted you while you were on a roll. And you've done well, buddy. You got any other points to make on Kardashians and Brown?
No, I just can't.
Why do you watch the Kardashians?
For Kim. I'm in love with Kim. I raise all her kids, bro.
Would you?
I raised when you.
Why do you even listen to Brown? Why do you even listen to Brown? He's gone.
Entertainment, man.
Okay.
Entertainment.
So he's entertaining.
Got to love it, man.
He went to practice today. You didn't even report on that.
Did he practice though?
No.
I do. You know, I tape all the Hard Knocks.
I know.
This year's during the Raiders, so it comes on tonight.
Wow.
So as soon as I get home at 4 a.m., I'm going to tune in.
The popcorn and peanuts will be ready.
Every morning when I drive home at 4 o'clock in the morning, I got a battle with McDonald's.
Really?
We're on breakfast now. At 3:59, I can get lunch.
I can
get a Big Mac at 3:59.
You want your
o'clock,
you want your quarter pounder with cheese?
Yeah.
Unbelievable. Just stop in earlier. Unbelievable.
And then they see it's me and they throw in a couple double cheeseburgers for $1.50 each.
Nice.
Two for three. Oh, we know what you want.
At least they know they know you. Thank you, Smokin' Jim Frazier. Got some bad news. We're going to do a show at the Millvale VFW 118, 605 North Avenue. Went to put up a Facebook event page today. Jose said, can we delay that? And he said, I didn't get back to you. I apologize. We can't do it on the 19th. So no show on the 19th. I got good news for Smokin' Jim and Steve Fisher. August 24th, Saturday at noon, we'll be at Joe Board's Boxing in Ohio. He agreed to the date. He's going to send me some information. But we're going on a road trip and a special edition of Pittsburgh Sportsline, filming exclusively at Board's Boxing, right outside of Youngstown, Ohio. So we're going on a road trip. Stevie Wonder's going to pick me up and drive me there. Steve Fisher will meet us there. We're going to do a show, and they're going to knock it out of the park with all their guests and boxers, and maybe even a couple sponsors or two might come out.
All
so
right.
We got a fun day lined up for noon on the 24th of August. So you'll see that show coming up, and we're talking about a couple other shows. So we'll see what happens. If not, we'll be back September 9th after Labor Day for another Olive Oils show at the Pizzeria in 930 Brookline Boulevard. So check that out. We had a nice group of people come in, good guests. And we had a four-time women's inline skating champion, Nicole Campbell. Didn't want to be on the show, was rather shy. Her husband was going to be on the show, and she said she didn't want to be. I said, you got to come on. I heard you're a champ. And she only told me she won like two championships. We got it out of her by a couple questions. Not only did she win two in a row, she won three in a row, and then she won four in a row.
Wow.
This past year, she just got married 3 months ago to Rob Campbell, a champion himself. But she won four in a row, and she'd love to be an inline skater the rest of her life. She just needs some sponsors. So I said, maybe somebody at Pittsburgh Sportsline watching the show will want to sponsor Nicole Campbell for inline skating. Her husband, Rob, three-time winner of inline skating. He's been doing it since he's like 7 years old. How about that? And he traveled all the way to Spokane, Washington to win. So they plan on doing different events around here. And he also has coaching responsibilities in Denora. He coaches young inline skaters. Good guy. We had Attila Domos, three-time Pittsburgh Marathon hand cycling champion. He won it for the third time, which that's a record for anybody to do. And he goes, that's not all. He goes, I'm 51, but I'm not quitting. I'm going to keep going. He has a special event on September 28th, 29th. Smokin' Jim said he'd show up at the Uber track in Hazelwood. He'll be trying to beat his world record of 407.7 miles. He's going to do a 24-hour marathon ride. And I saw it last year when he did it and only got 366 miles. What a performance he put on to do it. He was dehydrated and everything else, just terrible. The weather went against him. It rained that day. Wow. Then the sun came out and baked him. But a lot of people showed up early and late, like I did. and tried to root him in, and it was just great. He was there. He's going to Las Vegas to do a speech, and he wouldn't tell me what it's about. I couldn't ask him any questions about it, so we don't know what he's talking about. But he's going to Las Vegas with Gio Pizzo, so he'll take him out there with his buddy. We had the Pittsburgh poet on, Rachel Ann Bovier. I sell these polos, $20 for the Pittsburgh Sportsline polo. Need a close-up. I'll put it on the camera. I don't know if you can get me a close-up of that, Steve. This is the poem that Rachel Ann Bovier wrote, My Pink Polo by Pittsburgh Sportsline. So I don't know if you can see it. It's a little hard. Maybe if I tilt it down a little, you can see it a little darker. Get that camera back.
See it a little darker, and they put the camera on me.
I know. Stevie Wonder. There's the pink polo. Excellent work. Look at that. You can read it from top to bottom. I can't do justice and read it, but she even signed it, Rachel Ann Bovier. So now I got another pink polo poem. And she was quite the guest on there for a few minutes, and loved the color. Azalea pink was the color of the shirt.
Like that.
It was a nice color. Maybe Smoking Jim will get one like that.
I'm going to get one. I don't know what color yet.
Put it like this. You can get whatever color you want. Just tell me. And because it's 4X, it'll cost a little extra than 20. It might be $28, but we'll try to work that out. You never know. We'll work on that. But he's tough. He squeezes those dollars, so, except
what,
when he goes to the casino.
Give me a black.
You want a black?
Yeah, give me a black. Yeah.
All right. What size?
Big as they can get.
Nah, 4X?
Yeah, 4 or 5. Yeah.
Should I try 5X?
Yeah, try 5.
5X? All right, I might need 30 on that. I'll have to see if they can even make it. Folks, we got a dilemma. But yeah, we had great guests. I even had John Panaris, a tax man. If you need your taxes done, just Google John Panaris. He's just a great guy. He told a story that he got $16,000 for one of his clients. And they said, oh, the IRS gave it to you. And he goes, no, I asked for it, and I got it for my clients.
That's great.
So he's a great guy. Told us some sports stories, even pitching stories. Had 4 good pitches. Tore out a rotator cuff. Those things happen, and he became a tax man. So he'll do your taxes for you, and he helps people out. Where's he at?
Ambridge.
There you go. Smoking Jim didn't even know anybody who still works in Ambridge. But he's out there, and he'll work for you. Check it out. He had some great sports stories. He's a big sports fan, and he loves Pittsburgh Sportsline. He got a polo, a white polo. He looked sharp in that,
yeah,
so
he
looked good. I'm going to post the picture up that I took tonight, last night, with me and him. We'll show you that picture. And then Dan Bogan, the dreadlock DJ, he got a black double X. I held it up. It was only half the size of Smoking Jim, and Dan's a big man. But he came all the way in from wherever he lives and paid for his polo shirt and proud to wear it. So
he's the first guy I ever seen with dreadlocks that didn't wear Air Jordans. He had
what do you have on?
Yeah.
You got to line them up with your people.
Yeah.
$20 shoes, size 20. Get him a size 18, maybe. He may not want that size 20.
He had little generic tennis shoes on. That didn't go with the dreadlocks.
No, no, no. Well, he got a nice German Shepherd. He got to feed the dog. So. But we had a great show last night. A lot of fun. Who would imagine that these guys come out and they wanted Pittsburgh Sportsline polos? If you want them, contact me. $20 a normal polo shirt. If they're like Smoking Jim, it could be a little extra. If you're as big as Smoking Jim, you can still call me. We'll work it out. That's all I got on location. Stay tuned for more. And we're going to try to talk a little Bucco talk on the back end. It'll be short and sweet.
Hard dip bar throws. Here's a swing and a high fly ball going deep left, and they do it. Back to the wall goes Benny. It is home run.
From a very young age, I was exposed to sports in a great way. My uncle was on the first pro basketball team in Pittsburgh, the Pittsburgh Ironmen. And my dad, of course, that was my hero. He was a basketball referee for over 30 years. Just been a passion in my life. And as I got older, I found out about horses and I ended up owning a stable. And I was asked to be on a sports show with Roger Houston called the Meadows Racing Network. And when we were done, I said, boy, that'd be something great. Maybe someday I could have a TV show. Back in 2011, I had a conversation with some friends about sports that piqued my interest in how could we start a sports talk show on TV? Well, I found out I could go to public access TV in Bethel Park and I'd be able to produce my own sports talk TV show. The great thing about doing two sports talk shows on BPTV is I can share my passion about sports with thousands of people every week. If you are passionate about something that you would like to share with the community, I encourage you to come to BPTV and produce a show like I do. I'm Al Levine, volunteer producer of Pittsburgh Sportsline on BPTV.
BPTV, come volunteer.
If it wasn't fun, I wouldn't be here.
BPTV, come on in, make a show. It's still fun after all these years.
Bucko talk. Hey, they won a game last night, 10-2.
Wow.
Beat the Angels. I was been sleeping. The game didn't start till 10 o'clock.
Wow, they're on the West Coast.
Yeah, you could watch it because you're up. You have to check it out tonight. Another game.
Wow.
Maybe they'll win one for you.
I got a meeting.
What's her name? What's her name? Yeah, the Buckos, the less said, the better. I never saw Hurdle looking so bad after games. He looks beside himself, upset, frustrated. How could you not? They're making errors. They're dropping balls. They're getting out on the bases. They're making Smoking Jim happy. They're not going to get 78 wins on this pace. They've done one of the worst collapses in baseball history after the All-Star break.
I don't know. It seemed like that's every year.
No, this is worse. You don't really watch the games that much, so.
They're in the Guinness Book of World Records, and they didn't have to pay $16,000 to get Guinness to come out for their 20th.
Well, that's a North American record.
That's only North American?
Yeah, North American sports record.
Okay, I didn't know that. What's the record?
Well, they send the Guinness Book of Records everywhere, so other people got records.
Wow.
20 years.
The Roman Empire, it was more.
They were undefeated for 1,000 years.
That's what I thought. Yeah, that don't count.
Since Romulus and Remus, the two twins.
Maybe it's the Washington Generals that got the record.
Maybe.
But they're North American.
Yeah, we are. We're number one.
Okay, we're number one.
Yeah, we did it. But, yeah, that's enough Bucko talk. How about some Steeler talk? You talked about it lightly. Were you impressed by him for a first game, or what did you think?
I was very, very impressed. You know, everybody wants to talk about Devin Bush again. Like I said, he's a more athletic Jerry-O.
Ten tackles,
and most of them was on the first drive when they drove it all the way down his throat for first downs.
At least he was tackling somebody.
Yeah, I like that. He was hugging them to the ground. And, hey, at least you get them down to the ground, you know.
Put it like this. Your other guy, Lane, wasn't even touching him.
Well, if Kendrell Bell was in on 10 tackles, somebody would be leaving the game in a stretcher.
Really?
Yeah. You remember Kendrell Bell.
Yeah, I do.
That's the kind of guys
Didn't
I
a high ankle sprain take him out? Or?
He had a... degenerative shoulder problem.
He hit him too hard.
Yeah, he just He would have been right up there with Ray Lewis, one of the greatest of all time.
I remember him. He could hit.
But, you know, the Steelers get a lot of credit. Like I said, everybody offensively, everybody got superior receivers because the defensive backs are so bad. They give the Steelers scouts all kind of credits for bringing in receivers that everybody can do that. They have not had a quality cornerback. They were putting all their eggs in one basket, and it's Justin Lane. I told everybody he was a raw. He's basically a wide receiver playing defensive back. He's from Cleveland. His dad is a Cleveland, diehard Cleveland Brown fan.
Really?
But he faked out and threw out all his Cleveland stuff. That was phony.
Did he?
He got it right back out the garbage.
Wow.
So, I mean, it's a guy can't play. He won't tackle.
Hold it. You're a Browns fan now.
Well, I'm a football fan, and
yeah.
And most of the football players I like now play for the Browns.
Okay. I'm just trying to clarify.
I'm a college football fan.
Because even though you don't see that much, I know you see Browns.
Yeah, I see the talent.
And you wear Brown stuff every so often.
I see the talent.
They're not going to do it this year.
Huh?
They're not going to do it.
Baker
never beat a winning team. I told you that last week.
Well, he was only a rookie.
Yeah.
28 touchdowns.
And he beat
passes.
All losing teams.
And there'll never be another rookie quarterback throw 28 touchdown passes.
Really?
And not in our lifetime.
What's that young quarterback in Arizona?
He might do it.
He might have spoke too soon.
Well, he got my favorite receiver, although he got a bad knee.
Who?
White dude named Isabella. Remember that name, fantasy football people? Isabella. He's only 5'9", 185. Fastest guy in the league. Remind you of the late, great Cliff Branch.
Whoa.
And may he rest in peace.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You're bringing out some people, buddy,
yeah.
From the past.
And see, white guys can run. He's
really?
The fastest in the league, in my opinion.
Wow.
Isabella. And
I'll have to look for him if
yeah.
I can see him.
Yeah, he's super fast. He got a bad knee right now, but he'll be back.
You never know.
But the little quarterback's doing good so far. He was 6-for-7 in his debut.
That's not too shabby.
No, not too shabby. Can't get much better than that.
One better.
Yeah. How about my man Bruce Arians? Bruce Arians
him?
Do more for black people than anybody I know.
What do you do now?
First of all, that's my main man.
I know.
Bruce Arians.
Hall of
Famer.
Number
one, he wear the Kango hat. You don't see no white guys wearing Kango. That's a black thing.
No.
He played for Virginia Tech. He was shown he had a little black in him when he got kicked out of high school his senior year.
What happened?
He got expelled from his school his senior year, so everybody dropped the he was drinking and having sex with a girl. He ended up marrying her, but he was on probation. So he got kicked out of his high school. Everybody dropped their scholarships except for Virginia Tech. But he goes to Virginia Tech, which is in the South.
Yeah, yeah.
It's
yeah.
a Commonwealth state.
Yeah, yeah.
But he was the first white guy in Virginia Tech history to room with a black player.
Wow.
The black player was Tiki Barber's dad. So, yeah.
Get the heck
so
out.
So that was
this
something.
Is great fiction and fact.
Yeah. And then he was an old guy. You know, the Steelers mistakenly fired him. You know,
they weren't mistaken. They just wanted to get rid of him.
Yeah, they
made
the mistake.
They told him to retire.
They made the mistake of firing him. Ben didn't like it. Just like Antonio didn't like the helmet, Ben didn't like that. So they made a mistake. Chicago Bears wanted to hire him as their head coach. He turned them down because they wouldn't allow him to hire Todd Bowles as his defensive coordinator.
Wow.
So Todd Bowles, who eventually ended up getting a head coaching job at the Jets, but when he got the job with Arizona, he brought Todd Bowles in as a defensive coordinator. Now he's back with the Tampa Bay after he did terrible in the booth.
Yeah. He was bad.
Back with Tampa Bay. You got a black quarterback. I think you're going to see great things from Jameis Winston. Jameis Winston's the slowest black quarterback I've ever seen in my life. He ran for 30 yards against the Steelers, so the Steeler defense got to get a little quicker. Where
he
was
got
Bush
more
then?
Than Snell.
Where was, yeah.
He got more than Snell.
His offensive coordinator is Byron Leftwich, a black man.
How about he's advancing quickly? Charlie Batch said he never saw anybody move up in the coaching ranks like Leftwich.
Well, that could have been Charlie Batch, but he didn't want to pay the price to get into coaching.
He likes working with Pompeiani.
And plus, one thing about Leftwich, they always said he looked like the guy on Different Strokes. Isn't that Arnold? Is that Arnold? They always said he looked like that. But he ended up marrying one of the Schifinos.
No way.
And they're all the Schifinos look good.
Wow.
All the girls look great. Remember Angel, huh?
I know.
So he ain't all dumb. He ended up marrying the Schifino. He's smart. So I think he's going to be a head coach one day. He brought in Antoine Randall, and he brought in Nate Washington, who needed a job.
Wow.
So
he takes care of his people.
Well, he's looking out for the brothers. You know, you can't beat that.
How are they treating him?
They treating him good. What happens in Vegas stays in Vegas. I don't trust none of them guys, man. You trust them? Come on, man. All them guys is rotten. They just don't get caught, man. You get the brothers on your side, they ain't gonna talk.
Nah. I just treat them straight up, buddy. I don't care about the color.
How about the beginning of the game? Coach Tomlin got the sideline cracking up.
Yeah.
He ain't that funny. Yeah, I'm like, man, come on.
It looks like he gained some weight, too.
Coach Tomlin?
Yeah.
No, he stays in pretty good shape. Yeah,
Because I know you're close to him, even though you talk bad about him.
Yeah, I talk bad about him. They don't like for me to say that his son never made an all-star team in a day in his life, but he got a Division I scholarship. How's that happen? There's like three Division I scholarships in Western Pennsylvania last year. His son gets one.
Who do you know?
Exactly. And Coach Tomlin knows the head coach of Maryland and the running back coach of Maryland used to be the running back coach of the Steelers. So.
Wow. What a small world.
Yeah. So Maryland, they'd rather lose with a Tomlin than win with an all-state guy.
Wow. You're brutal, Smokin'
Chip. I mean, Dino's all right. You know, he'd have been all right.
How big of a kid is he?
He was a slippery rock guy, 165 pounds.
Ah, okay.
Yeah, he'd have been a slippery rock guy. Might have been a Division I track guy somewhere.
Oh, get out. Does he have some speed?
Yeah, he can run them hurdles, man.
Can he?
Run them hurdles.
Have you seen him?
Oh, he liked to run over sticks. Yeah.
Really?
Yeah. But he didn't make an all-star team at a small school like Shadyside Academy, but he gets one of the biggest schools in the country to come after him, Maryland. It was a bidding war between Robert Morris and Maryland.
Wow.
Come on, man.
You're spilling the guts on this one.
Come on.
You're digging deep here.
Yeah. So I seen the same old special teams.
The kickers look great.
Yeah.
Boswell looked right down the middle with that 47-yarder and 33-yarder.
You don't put no pressure on him. He wants that $2 million bonus.
No, he waived it.
Till he makes the team. Yeah. They brought in somebody.
Who has the balls, pardon my French, to waive $2 million that's guaranteed for you.
And they bring in somebody that's there never would sign.
Yeah,
he waived
that $2 million until he gets on.
It's like him. He's like he's kicking against, like he's kicking
high
against
school
who?
Kid.
Yeah, he's like he's kicking against Mendenhall or something. You know, I mean, he got no competition. So
hey, I like his confidence.
But that's good too.
Yeah.
But he already got $5 million in the bank, so I guess he figured.
Yeah, but he choked up last year.
Yeah.
Big time choke. Something was in his head. He couldn't kick.
Yeah. A lot of them kickers. Who's Steve Blass? Was he a kicker?
No, he was a pitcher.
Yeah, same thing.
He couldn't get the ball over the plate.
Gets in their head, bro.
My man, you're not a true baseball guy. He couldn't throw the ball over that little 12-inch plate. That was the problem.
Same thing as a kicker.
Kicking the ball, you got to go through like about 10 feet in the air. Come on, man. You're way out of control.
When they lose it,
your scouting goes to football. It stops at the front door of baseball. It ain't coming in. No, you're not even close to reality there. I don't care what you say there. Unbelievable. Hey, were you at those Monroeville fights?
Yeah.
How were they? I needed a report. Nobody reported to me on what happened.
I came late and I left early.
Well, you had a picture there with Jamie.
Yeah.
Our girl, my BFF.
I was able to get a picture with Jamie, but for some reason, I think the fight started at 7:30. I got there at 9.
Wow.
And was in time for the first fight.
Really?
But I had a meeting at 10:30, so I had to leave. But
I don't even want to know what that meeting was about.
It was a nice crowd. G5 was there. He was asking about you.
Yeah.
They had all kind of, it was being streamed on some television station. So all of them were running around with tight suits on.
Were they?
You know, they wear the straight leg pants tight suits. And
yeah.
G5 had that on too, man. They're all running around.
How about the ring card girls? Any nice ring card girls?
Well, they had one blonde.
I knew you'd give me a scouting report there. Okay.
And Lil Z was there.
Of course.
Lil Z was there because it was Pinnacle.
Yeah.
But
Victor Olive put that on.
Yeah, Victor Olive Watson. Chevrolet was one of the sponsors. He did the ring announcements.
Yeah.
Greg Rudolph will do. I think they're going to have another fight in November.
Well, how did
Greg
he do Rudolph in his fight?
He only had 3 weeks to get ready, so he didn't fight. But he's going to fight in November.
He didn't fight.
Yeah. So he couldn't really get. He didn't want to get ready in only 3 weeks. Like Kama Worthy's getting ready.
I know UFC. What an accomplishment.
That. Yeah. Yeah, we're going. Is that pay per view ticket?
I think it's pay per view.
We might have to come to your house and watch it.
I'm coming to your 90-inch screen.
After the Stiller,
I'm coming to your house with a 90-inch TV screen.
After the Stiller's preseason party,
yeah.
But hey, some great things are happening locally.
And that was in downtown Monroeville.
I was in downtown Monroeville, plenty of parking. Everybody had a great time.
No shootings or anything.
You didn't even have to lock your car. Man.
Really?
Yeah.
Was it there when you left?
Yeah. The Doubletree Hotel's right there, you know, if people want to lay their head down, man. So it's just great. The lights was on, shining, man.
Were the fights any good that you saw?
I'm trying to think. Oh, I'm trying to think. Yeah, there was one, man. They had this Hispanic kid, I don't know, out of New York or something.
Yeah.
Woo! I'm telling you, man, this guy got a chance to be the greatest. I was sitting, he got a chance to be, his combinations were so
We're
sweet.
Almost out of time.
Oh,
buddy.
My fault. Go ahead, Machine.
All
we'll
right.
We'll get back next week.
Well, thank you for watching us. Smoking Jim got a little carried away, so did I. Hope you enjoyed it. Had a fun show. We're glad we could present this Pittsburgh Sportsline TV show to you. We have a lot of fun. I try to tell you the truth. He tries to exaggerate a little bit. Somewhere in between, we find out what's really going on. He's against all kinds of discrimination, especially against white cornerbacks. Please stay Joey Strong.
Just been a summer job. But for me, it was training. Now I'm an Air Force pararescueman, and my job is to save lives. Make the right choices today and be ready for the challenges tomorrow. This message is brought to you by the U.S. Air Force.